In the last video, we studied about the interconversion of potential energy and kinetic energy. We studied how potential energy converts into kinetic energy in cases of pendulum, in cases of dropping of a ball, or in cases of throwing a body upward, it will go upward and come downward. In all these kind of cases, potential energy and kinetic energy got converted into each other. According to the motion, they got converted into each other. So there is another way of saying this statement. I am saying potential energy and kinetic energy are getting converted into each other. Or I can also say that potential energy and kinetic energy are conserved. Being conserved means not getting lost. If we conserve something, we protect something, it is not lost. So if they are changing into each other, that means none of the potential or kinetic energy is getting lost to the surroundings, or we can say that both of them are conserved. So this brings us to a very important law in science, which is called law of conservation of energy. And this law says that energy is always conserved because we cannot create or destroy energy. It is a very important thing. It is a very small statement, but its meaning is very deep. We cannot create or destroy energy. Very simple thing to understand. But if you think about it, can we not create energy? If I start the fan, then am I not creating wind energy? If the fan starts rotating, there will be wind. So I am starting the fan to create wind energy. If I am switching on the bulb, then I am creating light energy. If I am kicking a ball, a football, then I am creating kinetic energy. If I am throwing this marker upward, I am creating potential energy. So am I not creating these energy? Why does it say that we cannot create or destroy? Why? I just gave you examples. But if you look carefully, if you think about it, am I actually creating these energies or am I just transforming these energy? When I am switching on the fan, when the fan is working, what am I actually doing? Am I creating wind energy? I am not creating wind energy. I am only converting electrical energy into wind energy. The electrical energy of the switch, of the power that is coming, that electrical energy is converted into wind energy by using a device called a fan. And electrical energy is converted into light energy by using a device which is called a bulb or a tube light, any light emitting device. If I am throwing this marker upward, what am I doing? I am not creating kinetic and potential energy. I am only transforming my muscular energy into potential and kinetic energy. That means we cannot, this statement is correct, that we cannot create or destroy energy. We can only transform energy. We can only transform energy. The only thing that is in our control is transforming energy from one form to another form. I'll give you another example. All of us have heard about thermal power plants. We have studied in earlier classes that in a thermal power plant, we burn coal, electricity is produced. Now this statement, for a common man, this statement is okay that electricity is produced. But are we actually producing electricity? We are not producing electricity. We are taking coal, we are burning it. So that means we are using the heat energy of the coal and we are converting that heat energy into electrical energy by using various devices. We are only converting energies. We are only transforming energies. So that means we cannot create or destroy energy. And because of this, that we cannot create or destroy energy, the energy always remains conserved. It is never lost. It is always there in the surrounding. Energy on one and one thing, energy on one side will be equal to the energy on the other side. But it can be possible that the type of energies on both sides can be different. इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी विल बी इक्वल टू द विंड एनर्जी जनरेटेड बाय फैन, बट यू माइट से दैट द टू एनर्जीज आर डिफरेंट. दैट इज करेक्ट, द टू एनर्जीज आर डिफरेंट बिकॉज वी ट्रांसफॉर्म वन एनर्जी इनटू अनदर टाइप ऑफ एनर्जी, बट द टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी विल ऑलवेज रिमेन सेम. सो इट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लॉ एंड इट इज वेरी वेरी मच, इट कैन बी स्टडीड इन वेरी मच इन डेप्थ, बट इन योर बुक इट इज जस्ट हाफ अ पेज ऑफ वर्थ दे हैव गिवन टू दिस टॉपिक. And for that, you have these three statements and this example that is important. So try to understand them, and if you have any problems, you can ask me.